Now let us try to solve this problem whereby we are given a charge Q1, Q2, Q3 each equal to Q at the vertices of an equilateral triangle of side L. What is the force on the charge Q with the same sign as Q placed at the centroid of the triangle? Okay, so somehow the figure is like this. And I have maybe A, B, C. Okay, so this charge is Q, this is Q, this is Q. And at the centroid of the triangle, we have placed a charge capital Q. Same sign as any of these, right? And we are required to find out the force on this charge capital Q, correct? Now there is one way that we have already learned which can be applied to solve this, and there is another way which I'll tell you after we have gone through this. So we'll solve this problem by two methods, and one of the fundamentals is a bit different from what we have just seen, the force on the multiple charges that we just saw. We wrote that F1 is equal to KQ1 summation I is equal to 2 to N QI upon R1I whole square into R1I cap. That is your F1. This is what we wrote, right? So I'll first use this method to solve this. Okay. Now, let's try to understand. What happens is, for this to work, I have to specify my origin. Understand? I have to specify my origin. Now, it's completely up to you how you specify it. You can take the central charge to be the origin, you can take this to be the origin, you can take this to be the origin, you can take this to be the origin. And in all the cases, you'll find, and it is interesting to understand that the force remains the same. Whatever is the force, you'll get the same force, right? So, you tell, Which should I take the origin? This charge? Or this? Which? This? This. Okay. So let us take this as the origin. Fine. Okay. But then you'll have to understand the thing that if I draw this 90 degree, then it will pass through this vertex, okay? No? Because a median through this passes through the centroid. Centroid is, after all, the intersection of the medians. Median is what? Median is nothing but the shortest. It is from a vertex, you join the midpoint of the opposite side. Okay, it's not the shortest. Here it becomes the shortest. In an equilateral triangle, it becomes the shortest. This is also 90 degree, right? So this is 90 degree. Now, try to understand one thing. What is this length? That I know. Do I know that? No. This length, this. What is this whole length? That I'll be able to know. AC is L, and say this is D, then DC is L by 2. Is it not? So AD square is equal to AC square minus DC square, which is equal to L square minus L by 2 whole square, which is equal to L square minus L square upon 4. Which is 3 upon 4 L square. Correct? This is AD square. What is AD then? AD is equal to root 3 upon 2L. Now there is a property that the centroid divides this. Okay, the centroid divides the median in the ratio 2:1 starting from the vertex. Okay, so if this is 2k and this is, and this k, so let me, this is 2m, then this is 1m. So this total length is 3m. So that is only 2/3 of this length, right? So AQ is equal to 2/3AD. So that becomes 2/3 into root 3/2L, which gives me L upon root 3. So this length is L upon root 3, lies on the y-axis, right? Because I have designated this as my x-axis and this as my y-axis. Do we get that? So what is the coordinate of A? Since it is at a distance of L by root 3, and the x coordinate is 0 because it lies on the y axis, the coordinate is 0 L upon root 3. Okay. Fine. That is AQ. So I know the coordinate of A. Your next thing is to do what? You try to find out the coordinate of B and C. Now, how do I do that? This is at a distance L by 2 from here along the x-axis. So, the x-coordinate is L by 2. And how much below this? What is QD? QD is 1/3 times AD, which is 1/3 into root 3/2L, which is equal to 1/2√3L. Even otherwise, half of this, no? If that is twice, this is 1. So this is L by 2√3, and this is below the y-axis. Along the y-axis or parallel to it, below the y-axis. So this becomes minus L upon 2√3. Correct? Get it? Same with this. This comes to the left by a distance L by 2. So the x-coordinate becomes minus L by 2. And the y coordinate still remains the same. It is the same distance below, right? So it is minus L by 2√3. Okay? Do we get the point? Fine. Now we apply the concept of, of this force to this. Okay? We apply the concept of force to this point, and what do I get? Let this point be E. Okay? So what do you do at all times? Okay, you take, so this is your charge number 1, is it not? This is your charge number 1, because we have been, according to this, we have been taking the forces on charge Q1, correct? Now what happens? So what happens is F on Q, okay, or F on force on E, I am saying, that is equal to K. R will automatically come, no? all r's will come, no? What is this r? I want this r, no? What is r? R is from the origin to the charge of interest, right? So what is your r1? What's your r1? R1 is? Come on. R1 is the position vector of the charge on which R1 is the position vector of the charge on which you are taking the force. So that R1 is 0 I cap plus 0 j cap plus 0 k cap. Is it not? Try to understand the convention. Convention was that R1 is the position vector of the charge on which you are taking the force. But since you have kept your origin at that very charge, so your R1 becomes this according to this convention. So this is here, no? So what is that vector? That vector is nothing. 0 I cap plus 0 j cap plus 0 k cap. I designate this as say Q2, right? Now what is Q2? R2 is from origin to the other vector. So that is what R2 is. And see, since we are taking it in plane, maybe I can do without this k cap, right? It is in the same plane. It is a planar thing. So z does not appear, right? So r2 becomes what? From the origin to the charge q2, correct? So what is that? Rather this is what, you know, this is what r12, is it not? R2 is what? R2 is 0 I cap plus L by root 3 j cap. R3 is what? I'm calling this as R2, right? This as R3. R3 is what? R3 is minus L by 2 I cap minus L by 2 root 3 j cap. R4 is what? It is L by 2 I cap minus L by 2 root 3 j cap. Okay? Now R1 2 will be what? R1 minus R2. Is it not? It is R1 minus R2. Conventions. Okay? I am doing nothing. I am just doing the convention. R1 minus R2 is what? This minus that. So it becomes minus L by root 3 j cap. This 0 I have not written. Okay, 0 I cap I have not written. So R, and you require all these, no? R1, 2, R, R1, 3, R1, 1. R1, 2, R1, 3, R1, 4. Sorry. R1, 3 will be what? R1 minus R3. So it is L by 2 I cap plus L by 2 root 3 j cap. R1, 4 is equal to? R1 minus R4 is minus L by 2 I cap plus L by 2 root 3 j cap.
Origin we have taken as Q.
Yeah, somehow I asked the people where to keep the origin. So they said the charge on which you are taking the forces, that should be kept as origin. So I have done that. I could have taken it here. No issues, nothing. But then you have to be very, 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 very clear about what all position vectors we are taking. Okay. Because R1 is from the origin to the charge on which you were taking the forces. So and since you have coincided both of them, so that's why this R1 becomes 0 I cap plus 0 j cap. Okay, so Fe is equal to K. I'm starting with this. K Q into Q upon R12 whole square into R12 cap. That's what? Plus K Q Q R13 cap divided by R13 whole square. That is the whole beauty of it, no? It becomes iterative. You don't have to even apply your brains after a point of time. If you understand everything, then you just keep on plugging the values. Fine. That's why the understanding of this that we did in the last video, that becomes very important. Okay? So R14, so R13 cap plus K Q Q upon R14 whole square into R14 cap. Okay? Now what is R12 cap? R12 cap is this divided by mod of this. What is the mod of this? So it is minus L upon root 3 J cap divided by L upon root 3, that becomes minus J cap. R13 cap is equal to L by 2 I cap plus L by 2 root 3 J cap divided by L by 2 whole square. So L square by 4 plus L square by 12 root over that. So L square by 4 plus L square by 12 root over. What is this? This is 3L square by 12, so 4L square by 12, is it not? So that becomes 2L by 2 root 3, is it not? This becomes 2L by 2 root 3. What does that become? So it is L by 2 I cap plus L by 2 root 3 J cap divided by, this is what? 3L square by 12 plus L square by 12, that is 4L square by 12, obviously root over, so this becomes 2L by 2 root 3, root over 12 is 2 root 3, so 2L divided by 2 root 3, which is nothing but L by root 3, is it not? L by root 3, so L by 2 divided by L by root 3 becomes root 3 by 2L I cap plus root 3 by 2 I cap, yes. And this is L by root 3, so that goes up. So it is L, sorry, plus half J cap. Now if you find out there, if you try to find out its magnitude, it will be this square plus this square root over. This is 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4, that is 1. 4 by 4, that is 1. So yes, it is the unit vector. I'll erase this. This was the rough work. Now I have R14. Now it's easy because it is the same thing. This is negative. So it will remain the same, only this becomes negative. Right? Correct? So I can write that. So R14 cap is minus root 3 by 2 I cap plus half J cap. Correct? Now I plug in those values here. So it becomes KQQ. I just withdraw outside. Okay? R12. What is R12? Is mod R12, right? R12 is mod R12, correct? So what do I do? Let me erase this, right? Okay.